guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be something a little bit different from my channel. I've never done one of these, but I'm going to be doing a DIY video. And I've been watching these a lot lately, trying to DIY stuff for my dorm. And I just enjoy DIYs in general, so I wanted to show you all one of mine as I did it today. And what I'm going to be showing you is how I painted this calculator cover. And this is just in the Lilly Pulitzer, like the classic rose print, like I had on the pillow in my dorm hall. And I just chose this one because I think it's probably one of the simplest to paint. So I'm going to show you all the products that I used and exactly how I did it. I hope you guys enjoy and let's get into it. First, I'm going to show you some of the things that you'll need to do this. You'll need clear spray paint, white spray paint, a pack of paint brushes, preferably with some that are larger and some that are smaller. A cream colored acrylic paint, hot pink, a peach color, a mint green or aqua color, lime green, darker green, and black. You also need a cup of water to clean your brushes off with, and a couple of styrofoam or paper plates just to put the paint on for mixing. You can see that I've already spray painted the cover of mine white. My calculator is actually a charcoal gray color, but you want to start out with a white base. I'm going to pull up a picture of the pattern that I want to use just so that I can look at it and it'll help me do this a little easier. I'm first going to start out with the background color, which is a mint green, and this one's called Key West, and this is just an acrylic paint from Walmart. These are about a dollar a piece. So I'm going to start out with that mint color and the largest brush that I have, and I'm just going to cover the whole cover of the calculator. I also want to make sure to get the edges really good just so that no white is showing through. After you're done with that, you want to let that dry for a little bit before you go on to the next step. Now I'm going to go in with a few different colors and mix them. I'm first using this hot pink color. And also a little bit of this peach color. And I'm just using small amounts of both of those, not too much. And I'm going to use a pretty large amount of a cream color and mix in with those to lighten them up. Just because I wanted a more peachy pink color instead of just a pale baby pink. So you can see that I use a pretty good amount of that cream color, and then I'm just going to mix all those together. And this is going to be the first color for our roses. So after I get that how I want it, I'm just going to go ahead and try to figure out where I want to put the roses. And you kind of want to space these out as evenly as possible, but you don't want them to look too perfect either. So that's the hardest part for me, is just deciding where I want to put the flowers. The circles do not have to be precise because Lilly Pulitzer artworks are normally pretty abstract. So I'm just figuring out where I want to put those and then kind of dabbing it on in like a stippling motion. You can see I'm just trying to figure out where I want to place them before I actually lay my brush down. Just take your time with doing that because that's really the main thing that's going to make this look good. Now that I have that on there, I'm going to let that dry a little bit before we move on. Then I'm going to take a little bit more of this hot pink color and I'm going to mix that in with the color that we just used to make a little bit deeper pink. I didn't want it to be quite as bright as what the pink already is, so I am going to mix it in with that a little bit. And I'm using a smaller brush for this so that we can be a little more precise. Now I'm going to go in and do more details on the roses. And the way that I do this, to try to make it look as much like the picture as possible, is just to kind of go in with C shapes all around the outside of the roses and on the inside. The main thing for me when I'm doing this is I don't want the C shapes on the outside of the roses to touch. And as you can tell when I keep on doing this, I normally do about 3 of the C shapes along the outside of each rose, just because having an odd number I think makes it look a little prettier. So I'll do a few C's along the outside and then some in the middle just to give it some more detail. And you'll go back in with more colors because the lily pattern that we're doing this after, I think there's like 4 different colors in the roses. So this doesn't have to be perfect, you're just giving them more detail. My calculator has like a pattern imprinted on the front of it, so if it had been smooth, this would have been a lot easier because I think that was kind of making mine look a little more messy than I wanted, although I still think that it turns out good. If you have a calculator that has like a flat surface on the cover, I think this would be a lot easier. I'm just kind of fast forwarding through this a little bit because I'm just doing the same thing on each of these flowers, putting about 3 C shapes around the outside and then doing some in the center. I think doing this part took me the longest. When you go in with the other colors, it doesn't take near as long because you're not using as much of them. So now I'm going to mix in a little bit of cream with the lightest part that we used, our base color for the roses. I'm just going to mix in some cream to make that a little bit lighter. And we're going to do a little more detail work. So I'm just taking that small brush again after I cleaned it off. And I'm going to mix those two together. And as you can see, I'd already done the top 3 there. I'm just going in and doing some more small C shapes, but I'm just going to do less of them. And I'm going to try to keep most of these towards the center. With the exception, like if the outer edges looked a little too rough for me, I was kind of going around and smoothing them with that. And this part does not have to be perfect at all because this color was really close to the color that I used at first. It's just going to give it a little more dimension. I think the more colors that you use, it kind of just makes it look better and more realistic. So then I'm going in with that hot pink color, and I'm actually not going to mix this one. I'm just going to use it as a straight hot pink color. And so we're going to go into that with a small brush and do even smaller amounts of this one. You'll see that I don't use much of this at all. I'm just kind of putting it throughout the flower wherever I feel like that there isn't much color, just to kind of, like I said, give it a little more dimension. Now, I initially thought about leaving it like this. I was just going to leave it with these colors. But when I was looking at the lily painting, I could see that there was some actual like stark white pieces in it. And I didn't have a white acrylic paint. So you'll see in a second that I do go in with that cream color again. and do a little bit more on the inside of the roses. And I know it seems like that I've done so many different colors, but in the end, I really think the more colors, it just makes it look a little more dimensional. So you just kind of have to be patient and not be so precise, not worry about it too much. So after I get finished with this hot pink color, you'll see that I use a little bit more of this cream color, go in, and really all I'm doing with this is almost like just dots. I'm not really trying to keep it too like in the C shape. I'm just kind of going in and highlighting some of the points of the roses, and I definitely don't do this on the outside. I just try to keep it more towards the middle. I think this is kind of just trial and error. There's no really exact way to do this, but I just ended up liking how mine turned out, and I thought that this might help someone. Then after you're done with the white, I'm going to go in with this lime green color. And this is going to be the lightest green for the leaves. And for me, the leaves are the hardest part to do just because I never know where to put them or how to shape them. But I'm kind of just doing a little bit of everything. Like I'm doing, some are kind of pointy, some are more rounded. I just try to make sure that every flower has a leaf on it. And then you'll see like right here, if I have more space, then I'll do like two leaves. So just kind of, you don't have to be too particular with this shade just because, as you can see, it doesn't show up too much, but I'm just kind of sketching out where I want my leaves to be. In the lily pattern, the leaves aren't even really shaped like leaves. They're just kind of green blobs, but like that's kind of hard for me to do. So I kind of shaped mine, I guess, a little bit more like leaves than what it is in the original pattern, but I still think that it looks really similar to it. Next, I'm going to go in with this darker green, and I'm just going to put a few streaks of this like around the outer edges of where we put that lime green color, just to make it stand out a little bit more. And I feel like you kind of do have to be precise with this part. This is the only part of doing this painting that I was kind of not digging so much on mine, just because I feel like you kind of have to be particular with where you put the darker shades in this. I think it ended up turning out okay, but if I were going to do it over again, I think I would have just kept it on the outer parts of the leaves. Like where right here, I'm doing it on the inner part. I think it looks fine, but I think it looks best if it's just more towards the outer edges. Now, I would be fine with leaving it like this, and I feel like that this looks just fine. But looking at the original lily print, there is like three different shades of green in it. So I'm going to try to make like a darker green. I didn't have one, but I'm going to use a little bit of this black and just put a really small amount in there and mix it together with those green shades. And I'm not going to use much of this just because I didn't want this to get dark. So I'm just taking it on the smallest brush that I have and just placing a really small amount of that right on the outer edges of that second green shade that we used. Thank you. like the light, I do think that this helps to give it a little bit more dimension. It's just a step that you wouldn't have to take if you didn't want to, but I do like how it looks with it. Then I'm just kind of putting my phone beside of it and going in and touching up any areas that I think look a little too dark or need to be changed a little bit. Like I'm going in with my lighter green right there and kind of going over that darkest color just because I thought it looked a little too dark. And you'll see that I'm kind of doing that right here too. I wanted to brighten those parts up a little bit and just kind of fixing whatever I feel like needs fixed. So that's the finished painting part of the calculator. I'm going to let that dry a little bit. And then I'm going to go in with this clear spray paint and give it a generous coat. And you'll see how shiny that makes that after I've spray painted it. That's the finished product. And I think that spray paint really helps. It makes it very, very shiny, as you can see. Plus, it'll keep the paint from chipping off. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know this was something a little bit different for my channel, but I really enjoyed filming it. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe if you did enjoy it. And give this video a thumbs up if you want to see more Lilly DIYs. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope I'll see you next time.